Welcome. So today I'm going to be talking about making laws based on feelings. So let's move to the first clip.
Scottish police said that they were going to allow male rapists to identify as female. Mm-hmm. Now, what did happen is there was a male who was a sexual, sexually violent felon. I'm trying to, okay, look. A dude who raped somebody, then claimed he was a chick, got put into prison, and allegedly raped another woman.
What?
I like that courts are also playing pretend.
Yes.
Yeah, isn't that nice?
So on Sunday, J.K. Rowling, author of Harry Potter, tweeted in response, "War is peace, freedom is slavery, ignorance is strength. The penised individual who raped you is a woman." Mm. Great.
Penised individual?
Yes. Logical sentence.
Well, what else do you say when you say man? They say can't say man. Then you say male, can't say male. Penised individual?
That's right. After I saw this clip, I had to go research it myself to make sure that it was true, because I don't like just giving out information if I haven't checked it for myself. And sure enough, Snopes says it's true. Fact check, true. But the part that I found interesting is how they attacked the author of the Harry Potter books because of what she said.
War is peace, freedom is slavery, ignorance is strength. The penised individual who raped you is a woman. Hmm.
And they came after her for that. They said now she is taken to Twitter to paint trans women as rapists and civil rights as nonsensical. The article criticized Scottish police for honoring a prisoner's gender identity. Now, before I go any further, I want to say that this is not an attack on anybody that is in a same-sex relationship or anybody that is dealing with gender confusion. God does not force his goodness on anybody, and he gives everybody the freedom to choose. I place before you life and death. You choose. Choose life. But he still gives you the freedom to choose. And he's so confident in himself that he says that if you reject discipline, you only hurt yourself. You don't hurt God by rejecting him, because his whole desire is goodness for you, but he's not going to strong arm you into receiving it. So if that's the path that you want to take, he'll allow you to take it. He will turn you over to yourself. So being a daughter of the Most High God, I will behave the same way. But I will say that even though I believe that you have the freedom and the right to choose, I do not believe that because you've made a personal life choice, now the government is obligated to make laws to accommodate that life choice. It's called civil rights. So, I mean, with your line of thinking, then the blacks should have never been free. We should have never made legislation to free the blacks. My darling, that is not the same thing. And let me tell you why. First, God does not look on the outward appearance. That is man that does that. In the Word of God, it says that he looks on the spirit. He's not for racism. And to further prove that, all we would have to do is look at Moses. Moses married a Cushite woman, and his brother and sister didn't like it. Because they didn't like her, they thought that they could speak up against Moses, and God had to call them on the carpet. And it said that when he lifted, that Miriam's skin was leprous. But you also see the same thing with Peter. Now, after Jesus had ascended, Cornelius was praying. And before he could send Peter to Cornelius's house, who was a Gentile, and back then they didn't deal with them, he had to prepare his heart for that because Jews didn't intermingle with Gentiles. So he lowers down a blanket with all of these defiled animals. And he tells Peter, arise, kill and eat. And Peter's like, no, I ain't never ate nothing defiled. And at the end of it, God says, do not call unclean what I have cleansed. And he was getting his heart ready to go to the Gentile. God is not for racism. So this piece of legislation that was done to free the slaves was done in righteousness. Because God does not look on the flesh. He looks on the spirit. But this is something different. This comes out of the rejection of the order of God. And all I have to do is take you to Romans chapter 1. We're going to start at verse 25. They exchanged the truth about God for a lie and worshiped and served created things rather than the Creator, who is praised forevermore. Amen. Because of this, God gave them over to shameful lusts. Even their women exchanged natural sexual relations for unnatural ones. In the same way, the men abandoned natural relations with women and were inflamed with lust for one another. Men committed shameful acts with other men. And so pretty much what he's saying is that because they rejected God, they rejected his order. And in doing so, he said, okay, if you don't want me, that's fine. I'll turn you over to yourself. That's why this situation is completely different. This totally goes against the order of God. Whereas to human rights, blacks being free goes in line with it. He's never been a racist. He created one human race. It was man that looked on the outward appearance and began to divide people up. That didn't come from God. So that's why your argument is not valid. But you're cute, though. But to go back to the topic at hand, there was another situation that took place in Loudoun County, Virginia. You probably heard about it, but if you didn't, I'll just give you a quick summary. So there was a young man who raped a girl in the school, but because he's transgender, they don't want to say that. It was a boy wearing a skirt. It's just ridiculous. It was a boy wearing a skirt that raped a girl in school, and the school knew about it. They also knew that this young man had already been arrested twice in the same year for the same issue. So the father goes to the school board meeting and he addresses them and says, are you going to do anything about this? And he ends up getting arrested. Then the National School Board Association writes the Attorney General, Merrick Garland, and tells them about the situation and says, we need you to get the FBI involved. So the FBI is now involved. And now they want to label parents that are outraged across America as domestic terrorists. So instead of dealing with this young man and doing what was right, they flipped it. And now the parents are the evil ones. They're the ones that are guilty. And this poor young girl that was raped. And this is why you cannot make laws based on feelings. I feel like there's too many people that are going to jail for petty crimes. I got an idea. Let's just get rid of the petty crimes. I feel like there's too many minorities in prison. I got an idea. Let's release all the prisoners. I feel like too many minorities are getting abused by cops. We should totally defund them. So what do we have now? Well, what you see now is the CEO of Target, Best Buy, CVS, and other retail chains are calling on Congress for help. For what? We have states calling for funding to do what? To get more law enforcement. Okay. None of this had to happen, by the way. But when you govern with feelings instead of wisdom, you find yourself in a mess. And lastly, what I find most alarming about all of this is what they are willing to stand with in order to fight for the cause. They are willing to stand with a man that raped women, that identifies as a woman, to be placed in a prison with women, to continue raping more women, and to say anything against that makes you a transphobe. Ignore the facts, even with the other situation. They are willing to stand with a young man that already assaulted two other women, two other girls, and raped another young girl at the age of 14. They are willing to get the FBI involved to call their parents terrorists and stand with a young man that raped girls because he's a boy in a skirt. And to say anything against that makes you a transphobe. I don't know, when I look at this and I hear how people will defend it, regardless of the facts, regardless of the chaos, to me, it just sounds like deep darkness. Like, it's not just darkness, it's deep darkness. So again, this is not an attack on anybody. I believe that everybody has the freedom to choose. Adult. I believe every adult has the freedom to choose. And I don't think that anybody should be mistreated or abused based on the choice that they've made. But where we must resist and draw the line is where it goes into, now that you've made that personal life choice, that now you expect that law should be drafted up to accommodate that life choice. That's where the line must be drawn. But I just want to leave you with one last scripture. It comes out of Romans 8, verse 6. The mind governed by the flesh is death, but the mind governed by the Spirit is life and peace. I know that you've been blessed in your hearing, and as always, family, grace and peace.
Feelings. Nothing more than feelings.